that nowadays the career path of Thai researcher, yeah, the Thai researcher or faculty member at the university have been challenging nowadays. Yeah, so is there any survival model or is there any way to go besides being faculty member at university? So in this lecture and in this discussion, I would like to propose another model, a path to transform yourself from academic researcher to be entrepreneur. So I have a lot of reason. As I observed for 10 years, you see that 10 years ago, Thailand, in academic, the funding agency used to say to us that in Thailand, we have not enough PhD. We don't have enough, we don't have sufficient number of doctorate degree in Thailand. But what happened in the last 10 years, when university produce PhD graduate, they send this graduate to Rajapat University to fill the position, Ajahn position in Rajapat University. But nowadays, even the position in Rajapat University already full, no empty space anymore, no empty position. And where our PhD will go after this? You will see that. I have discussed with many friends. My friend, most of my friends tell that we have to send this graduate abroad to do postdoc in Europe or to do postdoc in United States or Japan or Korea. So we have realized that there is no position, doctor position in Thailand. No, not in university and not in the private sector. So, but for me, I already see the opportunity that for the graduate, the doctor graduate or master degree graduate, I think the opportunity is in the entrepreneurship. We can build a lot of startup company based on graduate student, based on PhD and master degree student. And that's why in this lecture, I will propose this model. And I hope you will, on audience will get some benefit, get some experience that I will discuss in this lecture. I hope it will be useful for you. Actually, I have around 80 slides, so it will consume maybe 2 hours if I discuss in detail. So I will skip some. I will skip some of slide. I don't want the lecture to be too boring. I will skip some slide and discuss the important points. The point to discuss in my presentation today is that you see that nowadays world change very quickly, very rapidly. And some people, they say that they want to shut their eye, shut their ear. They don't want to think anymore because they cannot follow the way the world is changing nowadays. You see, every business has disruption, including our university. And the new job market, I will show you later why the new job market, the globalization of the knowledge, weaken the role of university. Why the university, in the eyes of the new generation, is not as important as before. Why the new gen, when they look at university, they don't trust university like before. So I also will show you how I try to disrupt myself ahead of the time, to escape from this red valley. Because I see ahead that if I don't change myself, if I don't disrupt myself, then in the future, I cannot survive this disruptive change. Yeah. So disruption affect every corner of the society. Yeah, I will show you the slide to follow. Yeah, you see, probably if you are new generation, if you are under 20 years old, maybe you may never know this brand. Yeah, because this brand is a very big brand in my age. Yeah, 30 years ago is very big brand, but today it mostly disappear. Yeah, from the statistic, you see, now if you build a company today and in the next 10 years you have a chance 70% that your company will disappear. Yeah, you see the age of the company nowadays is shortened. Yeah, so 10 years ago, yeah, 10 years ago, the 100 list, the Fortune 1000, not 100, sorry. Yeah, the Fortune 1000 list the biggest capitalization, yeah, the biggest company, yeah, in United States. Yeah. And what happened after 10 years, they remain only 30%. Yeah. If you have 1000 company, very big 1000 company 10 years ago, today you have only 300 left. Yeah, 700 company poorer or even disappear. Yeah, and it does not matter how old is your company or how old is your university. You when the disruption come, it can happen in 2 years. And you see Kodak company is 130 years old and it's disappear in 2 years. Yeah. And not only Kodak, yeah, the new company like the Nokia. Yeah. Nokia used to be named the most innovative company in Sweden, in Finland. Yeah. And BlackBerry has many a lot of awards. Yeah. You see, but once the Apple released the iPhone, the first iPhone, then the stock price of Nokia and BlackBerry decreased every time Apple released the new version of iPhone. Yeah. So based on this fact, I also look back myself that, even today you have a very good idea, you are innovative, you propose something and you are successful. Yeah, but it cannot guarantee that in the next 5 years you will be still successful, or you will still surviving. Yeah, so nothing guarantee your success in the future. Yeah, so another bad news is that the change is not only coming quickly, but it's accelerated. Yeah. You see, this is the fearful side of the story. Yeah. Because the change is not linear, but the change is exponential. So it means in the next 5 years, the change, the accumulative change of the next 5 years will be even more than 30 years ago. Yeah. If you think last year, 2021, is already very fast change, has very fast change, you have to think again. This year, 2022, will have even more change than last year. Yeah. It will double the change. So this year, it passed already 1.5 months. But if you look back, you will see that there are a lot of change. A lot of people talk about metaverse. Yeah. And you see, if you look at the crypto, market, you will see that last year, we talk a lot about pay to earn or GameFi, but this year GameFi has already a lot of GameFi now today they already disappear. Yeah, even they just start two or three months, they already, a lot of company already bankrupt after just starting 3 months ago. So my prediction is that in the future, university will have no campus, or even it may have virtual campus in the metaverse. Why? If you look at many disruptor allow us, you will see that Uber now is the world largest company in the world. It own no taxi. The Uber, Grab also own no taxi, but it is the largest taxi company in Southeast Asia. Airbnb is the world largest accommodation provider. It has 2 or 3 million hotel room around the world, but it own no real estate. So Netflix, you see, if you add the Netflix, it's like a cinema. Netflix own no, if you compare to major cineplex, you see, when you want to see the movie, you have to go to major cineplex, right? But if you want to see the movie in Netflix, you just stay at home. So it own no cinema, Netflix, but it is the world largest movie house in the world. So why not in the future, we will have the biggest agriculture company, but this company own no land. They even have no land to grow food, but they are biggest agriculture company. It can happen. So no career, in my point of view, no career is secure. Even being a soldier, you think soldier, คนจบโรงเรียนในร้อย, you think they are secure job? No more, because in the future we will have robot. To fight, to replace soldier, to replace human. In the restaurant, the robot chef or robot cooker will do the job to replacing human. And even one smartphone now, it has more function than having doctor, nurse, clinician. In the future, it will replace even you see the plant-based egg replace the egg from chicken. So in the university, who know in the next 10 years, I will lose my job and to the robot. And this intelligent robot can scan the eye on student at once and can understand how to deliver knowledge to student properly. And this robot have empathy. They will not bully student. They will not hit student. But they will transfer the knowledge to the student much better than human teacher. So, and also, in the future, you can learn everything, anytime. You can plug in yourself in the metaverse and you can be fashion designer. You can do molecular simulation. You can do chemistry in the virtual world, do virtual laboratory. This is my student. He is working on material design in the virtual reality. You can even be a soldier to train to jump from the sky in a parachute without risking yourself in the real world, in the airplane. You train until you are good enough to go Parachuting in the real world, it will save your life. Yeah. So this is my concern. You see, the price to stay, to the price to enroll, the price to learn in university increasing. You see the price increasing, but the salary is flat. Yeah. You see here, we compare 30 years ago, at this, and we see how much, how many percent, is increasing for the tuition fee. You see that public university increase more because a lot of students want to go to government university. You see, government university increase the tuition fee much higher. In 30 years, it's almost 200%. Yeah. But how much the salary? Yeah. If you collect it with the inflation, the salary never increased along 30 years. Now, if you graduate a bachelor degree, you receive 15,000 baht. That's mad. That's crazy. My son, he said that when he graduate, he will not work in Thailand. He will go abroad. Yeah. Except he will receive 30,000 baht if the salary is less than 30,000 baht. He will not work in Thai company. Yeah. He will go abroad to Singapore or to whatever, to wherever. Yeah. So you see. That's very bad situation for university today. Yeah, very bad situation. And how you see the attitude of the graduates, of the student, of the new generation change. They don't love university anymore. Yeah, because if you study in Thai university, when you graduate, no matter how you spend the money, how much you spend your money, the money, they don't care. They give you 15,000 baht. Fifteen thousand baht. Very, very bad situation. Yeah. And the work in the future will change. Yeah. In the past, the work they in this slide you will see that the work in the past is not happy. It's red. It color is red because it's there are a lot of stress, a lot of systematic, a lot of factor that will keep you low level of happiness. But the dream work of the new generation. It's not a systematic work, but it is a fat organization. It's the environment that allow new generation to discuss, to propose, and to grow with the company. In the past model, when your company grow, you may not grow with the company. Even the company is very rich, you will not be rich with the company. But the future model, when the company grow, you grow with the company. And if we consider the future of work, we will see the trend that the new generation like to work as a freelance or the job hopper rather than to be the permanent employee of a company. So there are more number in, for example, in I think this one is from 2018, so it's quite old already, the data. But you will see that in China, around 45% of Chinese people, they are not employee, they are entrepreneur. In United States, 14, they are entrepreneur. They want to work for themselves. They are free worker. So you see that the gig economy will be the new norm of every country, including Thailand. Now I saw a lot of company when I work when I discuss with friend from the company, they said that nowadays it's very difficult to find new generation to that company, because the new generation, they want to own their own business, they want to work. You see here, the change gig environment. You can work from anywhere, and there are a lot of platforms on the internet that you can work with them. You can work with Amazon Mechanical Turk to earn money. You can work with Fiverr. You can even nowadays. For me, for example, I got a lot of job from abroad. I got a lot of contract work, contracted laboratory work from Germany. I got a job from UK recently. I got a contract from UK to do laboratory work. Nowadays, you can turn your lab into a global laboratory. You can receive funding from anywhere in the world. And I think in the future, most of the people will wander around the globe. After the COVID, more young generation will work like a tourist. They travel to many places, different places, maybe low cost to stay, low cost accommodation, and also cheap food price, and they work, get the work from anywhere in the world. We call this a digital nomad. There are also a lot of new career in the metaverse. And I think new generation, they already know this word already, to be a DeFi farmer, to play game and earn money. And even to be a scholar, receiving salary for playing game. So a lot of opportunity. So now I would like to propose the model. If from the previous slide, you may realize already that the future of university is not so bright like before. There are a lot of disruptive change that will challenge university. So my model, so why not our student or our ajarn, our faculty member considering to be entrepreneur researcher? So what is the difference between that entrepreneur and academic? You see that entrepreneur, the motivation for entrepreneur is the wealth, is the money. But for the professor, for the faculty member, they are motivated by publication. When you publish something, you are happy. As a faculty member university myself, before 10 years ago, I published a lot, but nowadays I decrease the number of publication, but increase the left side, I increase more money. So I will be much happy if our product can sell more product than publish more. Nowadays, if I publish something, I will not be happy. I'm not so glad. But if I can sell the product to customer, I will be very happy. So the motivation change. You see, and what bring impact to our career? If you are academic researcher, citation. More people to cite your paper been say how much impact you create. Yeah. But for entrepreneur, the customer, how much customer you have, yeah, create the impact. Yeah. Also, different playground, you see, when you show off, if you are academic, yeah, you show off at the conference. Yeah. But for the entrepreneur side, when we show off something, we show at the trade fair or exhibition. Yeah. So nowadays, I almost never go to conference anymore. Yeah. I send students, yeah, but I rarely go to the conference, to the academic conference, but I always go to exhibition. To exhibit our product in the booth. Yeah. For example, I go to Japan every year, yeah, to exhibit our product. Yeah. I go to Singapore, yeah, every 2 years, yeah, to exhibit our product. Yeah. And in Thailand, we have a lot of exhibition to go. Yeah. For example, this year we will go to around 3 exhibition. To show our product to the industry. Yeah. So in the past, yeah, you see, the past is the golden age for academic researcher. We have a lot of funding. More university in the past. In the 10 years ago, this is the golden age for university. Yeah. University expanding in the provincial area of Thailand. Yeah. There are higher birth rate, there are more students in the past, yeah, and more government grant. But now, university is oversupply, yeah, and decreasing birth rate means less students to enroll in the university, and much less government grant than number of grantees. So a lot of achan, but the grant is less than before. Actually more competitive. Yeah. It's very, very competitive. Yeah. For myself, it's very difficult to get government money. More difficult to get government money than for my customer. Nowadays, 15 years ago, 100% of my funding come from government. 10 years ago, my funding come from 50% come from government, another 50% come from business. And nowadays, 90% of my R&D money come from company. Yeah. Only 10% come from the government. Yeah. Maybe in the future, maybe 100% come from the business, not from government. Because when I get the money from government, I have to work a lot in the document. Yeah. It's not happy. Yeah. It's very boring task. Yeah, to you see, you get the same money, but you have to work a lot in the document. Yeah. And if we look at the funding from the government now, less money go to basic research. You see the basic research. This is called the technology readiness level. It say. The higher number, higher number means your knowledge or your technology reach the market. Yeah. So the less number, for example, 1, 2, 3, it means that it's still at the beginning. Yeah. You have to increase the number to be 8 or 9, yeah, to reach the market. Yeah. So you see that nowadays the money from the government to invest in basic research is less than 10 years ago. Yeah. More money come here. Yeah. Prototype development. Yeah. Come to this level. Yeah. I just got funding from the government grant to increase my TIL level from 8 to 9. I just got approved. Yeah. Of the funding last week. Good news, just last week, to upgrade my technology from 8 to 9 yeah, to reach more customer. Yeah. You see, if you are innovation at locate at 6, 7, 8, it's easier yeah, to get funding. Yeah. So after considering this, yeah, 10 years ago I think how I can survive, yeah, how I can survive this situation. Yeah. So I have a look at the new trend. Yeah. I have observed that you see this I think this one come out around the year 2020. Yeah. And they predict that in the next 5 years, which area in the world, which area in the business world have more opportunity. Yeah. So I see these two landscape, yeah, these two sector, yeah, AI and Internet of Things, yeah, have a lot of opportunity. So I think, oh, if I want to make business, I should go into this area because this area is very big. But why I don't go to battery? You see, the renewable energy is much smaller, yeah, and even advanced material, yeah, much smaller. Yeah. Biotechnology also smaller, yeah. But AI and Internet of Things very big area. That's why I go to this area, yeah, because a lot of opportunity. So. Then I try to convert to transform my research yeah, in sensor into three different parts yeah, into different three parts yeah. The first one is a smart farm yeah. I will show you later what is my strategic plan yeah, to create a business yeah, from research yeah. But here I just show you that I have the same core technology, but I divert the same core technology into three different markets. Yeah. The smart farm market, the smart industry market, and smart health market. Why? Because if you invest in stock market, you will understand it. Yeah. When we invest in something, we should delist, we should do risk management. Yeah. You should not invest anything in your life in only one thing. Yeah. For example, if you have 10 eggs, you should not put 10 eggs in the same basket. You should distribute the egg in different baskets. Yeah. This is my strategy. Yeah. So maybe if I do smart farm, maybe I will not success. So if I am not successful, maybe I will succeed in this part instead. Or maybe if I don't succeed in here, I still have another part. Yeah. So I try to decrease my risk by investing in different parts. Yeah. So that if I later I found that I can sell a lot of product in this direction, then I will invest more in this direction. Yeah. But I will still invest in other direction. Yeah. I will not stop or I will not I will not stop or decrease my investment in other direction. Yeah. Here this is a timeline. Yeah. You see you make question, you may have question that to turn basic research into business maybe is very difficult. It may take time. Yeah. Actually, this question, yeah, you are right. It's not easy. Yeah, to turn from basic research here until you can sell to the market. It's not easy. Yeah, but it can happen if you still go. If you always go forward, what does it mean? When you start your idea, then your TRL is one, yeah? And when you increase your idea, you increase, you prove that it works, then your TRL come to 3. Yeah, you get funding from government. Yeah. Then what I mean that you have to walk forward. It means that when you finish this project, when you finish this project, you should go ahead to develop the prototype. You should go ahead to 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. But most of Thai researchers, when they finish their project, they go back to 1 again. But they change the topic. For example, I give example, maybe some researcher, they work in, for example, the solar cell, for example. They can increase they can increase their knowledge in that type of the solar cell, for example. Okay, maybe first you work in the silicon solar cell, yeah, you increase your knowledge, and then you publish a lot, yeah, from silicon solar cell. And the next step is, if you walk into the number 4, 5, 6, it means you have to build prototype of silicon solar cell and try to up the technology level. But this research, they said that, okay, they finished the silicon solar cell. They want to create a new project to get the,
Okay, ฉันพบข้อมูลนี้ในเว็บไซต์เกี่ยวกับ OKB Finance.
Sorry, that's silly. Wake up. Then, this researcher, instead of going ahead, they go back to number one and they propose a new project. They propose to work in perovskite and get new funding. Then most of Thai researchers, they circulate in this area, yeah, in this comfort zone. They go 1, 2, 3 and go back to 1 and 2 and 3 again. Then you will never sell anything if you do something like that. Yeah. But instead, for me, yeah, when I start basic research for chemical sensor in 2006, I go to TRL level 1 to 3, yeah, 1, 2, and 3, and then I patent. Yeah, most of my patent we register 10 years ago. Yeah, most of my patent nowadays I rarely register the patent because I already come to the highest TRL. Yeah, but I try to go to our colleague, yeah, to find good basic research and try to fund them. Yeah, to, so that in the future I will have more advanced product. Yeah. Then in after 6 years, yeah, starting from 2006, in 2012 I developed prototype. Then I have to get funding from another source of money. I cannot get the same source of money anymore because the same source of money require me to publish. Then I forget it. Okay, you require me to publish. I will not get your money. I get money from other people, other funding. Then you have to go out of your comfort zone. Then in 2012, I developed the prototype, get funding. And 4 years later, I submit. I found the first startup company in 2016. And submit my proposal to Korea government, and we get approved, and we receive a business incubation in Korea. After we come back from Korea, we know how to do business, and so we test our product in with many big company in 2017. Yeah. The TRL level come to the 8, yeah. And this year, last year we create another company, yeah. And we get funding from another source of government money, yeah, PMUC, yeah, to upgrade our TRL 8 to TRL 9. Yeah. This is the year that we will scale up. You see, it takes around 15 years from the first day until now. So it's not easy, but it can happen if you always walk forward. Yeah. Don't walk back to do basic research. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. You have to upgrade your technological level year by year, and then you will reach the market. So I already found four startup company, and I have the idea that every student who come to our lab will own the stock in this company, and I will not be the manager, but I will take my role as the chief technology officer. I will take care. I will be in charge of technology development in our company. I will not work as a manager or CEO, yeah, because my skill is in the R&D. So I will invest my time, most of my time in R&D. So if you are a faculty member, don't be afraid, yeah, to build a company. You can find other people to help you. Yeah. You don't have to do administration job. For example, myself, everyday work is to do literature research, to find a new technology, try to improve our technology, try to improve our software, try to be competitive, to be better than other competitor, or try to have a new idea to increase innovation in our product. I never do tax payment. I never do invoice, PO, find customer or whatever. I never do it. Other people will do this job. I have lawyer, outsource the of lawyer. I have outsource the accountant. I have outsource marketing work to other people. So you will invest your time. Even now, if I quit from your university, yeah, my 100% job will be R&D. Yeah. Yeah. But I still like to work in university because I want to teach, yeah, to students. Yeah. But in the next 6 or 7 years, I will retire, yeah, from university and do 100% R&D. Yeah. So then the question is, what is the strongest area Thailand can do? Yeah. If you compare Thailand with other country around us, yeah, what is the best area that if you invest your life, then it will have a long time way to go? Yeah, not being disrupted easily. Yeah. So when I look, what is our competitiveness? I think the food industry in Thailand is very strong. Yeah. But in the future, if you don't invest in R&D, then it can be disrupted too. That's why food industry need a lot of innovation. So considering this, I think, okay, I should work with the food industry. Because the food industry, you know, they export around 1 trillion baht abroad. Yeah. And the food industry in Thailand is very big. Yeah. Then I see that if I invest, if I establish myself in this food industry, there are a lot of customers. Yeah. I am not interested in automobile industry because, okay, automobile industry in Thailand may be big, but there are not a lot of customers. It's not like food industry. Food industry very diverse. You can find a lot of customers. And we analyzed already that the total accessible market is very, very big for us. That's why I locate myself in the industry. So our four startup company locate itself along the supply chain of the food industry. You see, the farmer produce the food, We have Smart Farm Thailand to serve the farmer or the producer of the food. When the agricultural raw material go to the factory, we have Electronic Nose Company producing service and product for this part of supply chain. And when the industry process the food and send the food to the restaurant or retail market, we have another company to present our technology to this market. And then after the food go to consumer, we have some holding company that have the service and product at this the end point of the industry. So you see that along the chain of the food production chain, we have established ourselves. So this is the detail what company each company doing. I will go a little quick a listen faster now because we takes only maybe 40 minutes. But Ajahn Pim told me that I can have much time. Maybe one and a half hour. So I don't know you didn't want to listen or not, but maybe I will present next for the next 30 hours and give you some 10 minutes, 10 or 20 minutes for discussion. You see, most of our company, you see, this is our strategy. We locate in the food industry, and most of our company conform to the trend, the global trend. We know that AI market very big. We know that IoT market very big. And agriculture and food, maybe not big, but it's very big in Thailand. So this is the global trend, AI. IoT is the global trend. And agri-food is the local trend. So think global, act local. You may have heard about this word. When we think globally. But when we act, we act to the market in Thailand, we act locally. So that's why this is our strategy. And we conform to the global trend of digitalization. So our company is the digital company. That's why I received the, I have to, I would like to tell you that we received, when I received the funding from PMUC, we received from the digital sector of PMUC because we are a digital company. We are not chemistry company, physics company, we are not material science company, but we are a digital company. Why? Because we try to digitalize the good and service. For example, electronic nose and MUI robotic, we digitalization of smell, we digitalization of the environment, create the value from the digital data of what our sensor have received. For Smart Farm Thailand, we do the work of digitalization of farming, try to make farming into the digital world. And for the SIM company, we digitalization of the health. We convert the health data into digital asset, into digital information that can process or can make use of. So I will now and then I will tell you what each company doing in detail. Here, if we will come back to this slide often because I would like you to remember a little bit. Now we start with the Smart Farm Thailand. What Smart Farm Thailand is doing. Smart Farm Thailand is the company to digitalize the farming parameter. So we have our product and service. we have IoT product. We do Internet of Things for agriculture. We produce many sensors that will be used in agriculture. Yeah. We have weather sensor. We have water sensor. Yeah. We have smart greenhouse. We have sensor for paddy, and we have sensor for tracking machinery, tracking animal. Yeah. So here, this is a map of how can we utilize this technology, yeah, in the farm, yeah, in the beginning of the food supply chain is the farm. And we want to modernize farm in Thailand. Yeah. You see the usefulness of this technology. You can save water. You can do accurate farming. Yeah. You can you can monitor your farm anywhere, yeah, anytime. Yeah. And from this, you can increase the quality of your product. Yeah. So our product and service, yeah, have various type of application. Yeah. You can install it in the big area of the farm, yeah, to monitor your farm, outdoor farm. Yeah. You can install it in the greenhouse and make your greenhouse smarter. Yeah. And you can use IoT in shrimp farm or fish farm. And also in a pig farm or cow farm. Yeah. I will show you some example. Yeah. Here, this is the example how we install. Yeah. This is the this is the sensor. Yeah. The smart farm sensor that we install. Yeah. We develop our own algorithm and service and also AI. Yeah. To analyze the data, yeah. And we also have a chemical sensor, maybe the first in the world that can indicate the quality of the soil, of the nutrient in the soil, using electronic nose. Yeah. Yeah, this is example of our customer. Yeah. You can buy from 7-Eleven this enamel. Yeah. Yeah, they use our sensor. Yeah, this is also another example. We use it to help wine producer, yeah, in Thailand. Yeah. So, okay, another application area is the smart greenhouse. Yeah. You see, we have indoor sensor, we have outdoor sensor, we have artificial intelligence to control the environment in the farm. Yeah. For example, to control the temperature, to control the lighting, yeah, in the greenhouse. Yeah. We have also solar cell. Yeah, too. So this greenhouse will operate completely zero carbon free, yeah, because the energy they use from solar cell. Yeah. So it's independent, energy independent greenhouse. And yeah, we start to do this market in the cannabis industry. Yeah. So the next one, actually this number three, yeah, not number four. Yeah. It in the smart aquaculture, yeah, we have IoT sensor. Yeah. Here. Shrimp farm, and this one, this is the ornament fish, ปลาสวยงาม they grow ornament fish to export, yeah. So they have to control the environment, the good environment for ornament fish, yeah. And the next application is the to use IoT to track, yeah, the cows, and to this one is under development. You see the cow walk. Yeah. They walk in one day. They walk many kilometers. Yeah. So the next company, Electronic Nose Company, after we Okay, the Smart Farm Thailand, now the status of the company, we already profitable company. And this year and next year, we are expanding the market in agricultural sector. Yeah. So another company, Electronic Nose Company, what are we doing? Yeah. Our company is to digitalize the smell. Yeah. We use chemical sensor. We have IoT environment monitoring to monitor the environment around the factory. Yeah. And so we use electronic nose for quality control of several products. Yeah. Yeah, this is the product that we have today. Yeah. We have portable electronic nose. We have R&D service. Yeah. We are also only one company last year that receive funding from European Union. Yeah, as a private company, receive funding from European Union. And nowadays, I receive funding from my student company for my research. Yeah. I already receive many million Thai baht from my student to do R&D. Yeah. So it's very good if you create your startup company. Today, you pay to your student. Yeah. But in the next 5 years, your student will pay you. Yeah. This is very good sign of creating startup company for student. Yeah. So we have IoT environment sensor, yeah, and also drone. Yeah. This is our customer. Yeah. You see, we have a German, Nivea Eucerin. Yeah. We get funding from Horizon 2020. We get the funding from United States Navy. Yeah. This is some of our customer. And this company received funding from Korean government. Yeah. As I told you before, that in 2016, we get incubation in Korea. Yeah. And this is service and product, yeah, of our company, Electronic Nose Company. Yeah. And this one, this is also very big market, yeah, the environmental market, yeah, to monitor the factory. Yeah. Because nowadays, a lot of factory want to be green factory. Yeah. We have many products to guarantee that your company will be green company. Yeah. And we get also supported by PMUC, yeah, the R&D, yeah, to upgrade our TIL level from 7 to 8, yeah, in this area. Yeah. This is the our product, yeah, to monitor the smell from the factory, yeah, from the electricity generator, for example. We also have technology to monitor livestock. Yeah. So now the next company. Now, when you see the chain, you see that we have Smart Farm here, Electronic Nose here. And when the food travel from the factory to the restaurant, I try to think, how can I get involved in this area. Yeah. Because when you think about restaurant, you may think that, oh, in the restaurant, if you want to get involved in the restaurant market, you must have restaurant, or you may have to be a cook or chef or deck serve, yeah, the service man. Yeah. If you want to get involved, how can the technology get involved in this market? Now, I try to think a lot. How can I get money in this point of the supply chain? It's very difficult, yeah, to get money from this area. Even if it's big, but maybe most of the customer don't want technology. Yeah. Most restaurant maybe they don't want technology, but it's not true. Nowadays, restaurant want a lot of technology. here this is my roadmap of this company, yeah, how I can apply AI IoT robotics at the consumer end, how we can do that, yeah. So at present we have it Innos product, yeah, IoT Innos for smart factory. I already present to you in the previous slide. How can I get involved in the restaurant market? Then I look at this one. We have to go to the robotic. How if, because nowadays there are a lot of robot already employed in the restaurant and in the preparation market, the food preparation market. Yeah. Many, for example, in a cloud kitchen, yeah, they need a lot of automation. So I try to develop the technology, the artificial deliciousness technology, yeah, so that the robot can have a sense of deliciousness and can prepare the food according to human needs. And another area that I would like to enter is the metaverse. Yeah. We try to do transmission of food flavor or deliciousness digitally in the metaverse. Yeah. So we call this digital olfaction technology. Yeah. So here you see in the food preparation landscape, there are also already a lot of startups. Even it's very difficult to enter this market, but there are already a lot of startups. Restaurant using robot, you see, there are many restaurants and more restaurants in the future will use robot. So that's why I found this company. Yeah, we want to go in this area. Yeah. We want to develop technology for the use in a robot chef, robot barista, robot bartender. And we just get funding from National Research Council of Thailand to develop electronic tank. Yeah. So next year we will have more product. We will have electronic tank to work with electronic nose. Yeah. This one you see now we will have artificial sense and we will present this to robotic company, yeah, to work with robotic company to insert artificial deliciousness, yeah, into robot. Yeah. This is our plan. Yeah. And here, yeah, this is our business model, yeah, of MUI robotic. Yeah. And in the future, we will enter auto market, for example, smart toilet. Yeah. Then you can, when you go to the toilet, then you will know your health status, if you have disease or not. Just go to the toilet and you know the parameter of your health. Yeah, this is what we plan. Yeah. Okay, now it's near the end of my talk. Yeah. So we have three companies already. And then what is the end of the food supply chain? The end of the food supply chain actually is ourselves. As a consumer, you eat food at home, you eat food at restaurant, yeah. Everywhere you eat food, then this is the end of the supply chain. So my question is, how can I enter this market? How can we enter this market? So I try to analyze the market and I think food affects our health a lot. Yeah. Many people say you are what you eat. It means when you eat the food, you become the same as the food you eat. Yeah. If your food is healthy, then you will be healthy. If your food is not healthy, you are not healthy. So how can I enter this market? I think I should enter it in the health aspect. Yeah, to observe the health of the people who eat food. Yeah. So I established the SIM holding company, yeah, to do the digitalization of the health. Yeah. So that I will do synchronize our technology with the other company, yeah, other startup company, yeah. To if so for example, now if I do this along the chain, you have data, you see the data is the goal. Yeah. When you do this, you have data. When you do this, you have data. Here, yeah, you have data, and you can use this data for this company. Yeah, for the same company. So data is the goal, and human body has a lot of data. Yeah. And a lot of company try to get your data. Yeah, you see, this is the name of the startup company. It's allowed more than 200 company in the list that try to monetize, try to make money from your body. Yeah, you see a lot. And I see, and I think, oh, there are a lot of company here. How can I compete with them? Because there are a lot. So if I create a company here, I will be just one company list here. And I think, oh, very difficult. This market is difficult. So I try to differentiate myself. Yeah. I try to analyze what are they doing, yeah, and I observe that what are they doing. Most of the company do in just three area of the sensing, human sensing. Yeah. There are four area in the human sensing: biokinetic signal, you measure the movement of the body. Yeah. Physiological signal, you measure the signal released from your heart, from your rhythm, or from your blood, from whatever. Yeah. But this is physiological data, is the average data of your body. Yeah. And ambient, this is the environment sensor. Yeah. So less people working in this area, the chemical signal or biochemical signal. So I think to be differentiated from this company, yeah, a lot of company here, because most of the company here, they are biokinetic and physiological company. So I try to locate myself as the biochemical signal company, yeah, to measure the thing so called the volatome, yeah, volatolome, yeah, to measure the smell of the human body and convert this smell data into health information. This is what our company is doing. Yeah. So we work with Nivea, yeah, around 5 to 6 years ago to digitalize the armpit data, yeah, so that Nivea can design deodorant, more efficient deodorant. Yeah. We have a lot of prototype, yeah, to track the movement, the smell of the people for fitness. Yeah. And we also published one paper that we show that our technology can track the progress of healthy diet called ketogenic diet. And the company in the Silicon Valley contact us, yeah, that they are very interested in this technology because they want to create a wearable sensor that can track the use, the food diet. And we cooperate with the Ramathibodi Hospital, yeah, to track the diabetes. Yeah. And our target is to develop a device that diabetes patient can monitor themselves at home. Yeah. We are developing this. Yeah. And also we also work with Ramathibodi Hospital to detect liver cancer. And we can discriminate the we can diagnose the people who got cancer. Here we have a project with the US Navy to develop wearable sensor to detect the stress of soldier. Yeah. Also one of our patent, we also issue a patent, the wearable sensor, and now we get interest from a company in UK. Yeah, they want to develop a wearable sensor to detecting disease. Yeah. And now we got a preliminary contract. Next month we will complete this project, and it is possible that they will employ us another project, bigger one than this, because this company, they got funding from Bill Gates. Yeah. So I think this one is will be interested by Bill Gates. This technology. We also have work in smart toilet. And also recently we have employ our technology for detecting the COVID-19. That this is the work under focus. So this is the whole lecture. So thank you very much for your endurance. Yeah. It takes around more than 1 hour of the lecture, very quite long. Yeah. So thank you very much, Nong Kim. Yeah. I turn my talk to you now.
Thank you very much, Chanti Rekiat. I think this is such a motivating talk, especially for myself, who always do basic research. Anyway, now it's time for questions, maybe from students first. Yes,
Aslan.